A very good morning, dear students. In last class, we have seen about introduction of the second chapter, that is some basic concepts of chemistry. Actually, that is the first chapter in your syllabus, but I have already taught you about organic chemistry. So then I have started some basic concepts of chemistry. In that, we have seen about what is introduction. Now I'm going to explain about classification of matter. So in last class we have seen what is matter. So matter is nothing but anything present in the universe which is having some mass and occupy some space, that is known as matter. Okay, so especially this chemistry deals with the composition properties and properties of this matter and changes whatever occur in the matter, so that we need to know about what is matter and how many types of matters are present in the nature. In this video, I'm going to explain about classification of matter. Okay, here we want to know about classification of matter. So because different types of substances present in the nature, so they can be classified into different types based on different factors. So initially, matter is mainly classified into two types, that is mixture and pure substance. This classification is based on chemical composition. Okay, so based on chemical composition of matter, it is classified into two important types, that is mixture and pure substances. Okay, based on the chemical composition of matter, it is classified into two types, that is mixture and pure substance. So first we'll see what is pure substance. Okay, when we can say a substance as pure or matter as pure. So the substances which contains only one kind of atoms or molecules. Okay, a substance which contains only one kind of, only one type of atom or molecules. Then those are known as pure substances. The substances which contains only one kind of atom or molecule are considered as pure substances. Understand? So the composition of the substances in these pure substances is fixed. Okay, the composition of the elements or the substances in this is fixed. There is no change in its composition. Example, we can see CO2. Okay, so carbon dioxide. So this is containing same kind of carbon atoms and same kind of oxygen atoms. Okay, and there is no any other impurity exist along with carbon dioxide. That means a substances which contain same kind of atom or molecule, only one kind of molecule is existing, that is carbon dioxide. Okay, and the ratio is fixed in this carbon dioxide. Ratio of carbon and oxygen is fixed. That means composition of the substance is fixed. Okay, so that is the nature of the pure substance. So a substance which contains only one kind of atom or molecule are known as pure substances. The composition of the substance is fixed. Example, carbon dioxide. So carbon dioxide does not exist with any other compound. It is only a kind of or a same type of molecule, and the ratio of carbon and oxygen in it is fixed. Okay. And these pure substances are again classified into two types. Pure substances are again classified into two types. That is element and compound. Okay. First we'll see what is element. It contains only one kind of atoms. Okay. So elements contains only one kind of atoms. Example, sodium is an element. Okay. Na is a symbol of sodium. Sodium is an element. It contains only one atom. Copper is an element. It is containing only one atom. Silver is an element. Even it is containing only one atom. Hydrogen, oxygen are also example of elements because they contains only one kind of atoms. Okay. And they cannot be separated into its constituents by physical or chemical methods. Okay, so either by using physical methods or by using chemical methods, we cannot separate these elements into its constituents. Example, oxygen. It contains two constituents. They cannot be separated by using either physical means or chemical means. Okay, so the elements which contains only one atom. These are the elements which contain only one atom, and they cannot be separated into their constituent either by physical means or chemical means. Okay, that is the first type of pure substance. Next, second type of pure substance is known as compound. Okay, now we want to know what is compound. So if two or more elements combined, okay, if two or more elements combined chemically in fixed proportions, your proportion will be fixed. If two or more elements are combined chemically, okay, again it is chemically, then that is known as a compound. A compound contains two or more elements where they can be combined chemically in a fixed proportion, then that is said to be a compound. Understand? Example for such type of compound is ammonia and water. NH3 and water. So ammonia and water are examples of compounds. In this ammonia, they cannot be separated by physical means. Okay, nitrogen and hydrogens cannot be separated by physical means, but they can be separated by chemical means. But they can be separated by chemical means. That is called compound. So pure substances are mainly classified into two types, elements and compounds. Elements contains only one kind of atoms and they cannot be separated by physical or chemical means. In compounds, two or more elements combined chemically in a fixed ratio. Okay, such compounds cannot be separated by physical method, but they can be separated by chemical methods. Okay, so initially matter is classified into two types, mixture and pure substances. Now we have seen about classification of pure substance, that is of two types, elements and compounds. Now we'll discuss about types of matters, so types of mixture. See, just now I have told you compounds can be separated by chemical methods, right? H2O is an example of a compound. Okay, this contains hydrogen and oxygen in 1:2 ratio. Oxygen in 1 ratio, hydrogen is in 2 moles. So this is in 1:2 ratio. It can be separated by electrolysis. Electrolysis is a chemical method. Okay, so only by using chemical method, these compounds can be separated into their constituents. Understand? So properties of compounds are different from those of the constituents present in that atom, in that compound. Okay, so properties of compound is different from the constituent elements present in the compound. So what are the elements present in water? Hydrogen and oxygen. We know hydrogen is in gaseous state, oxygen is also in gaseous state, but whatever the water is formed, that is in liquid state. So the physical state of water is getting changed. That means the property of the compound is different from the properties of the constituent elements present in that compound. Okay, this is about the compounds. Compound is one of the class of pure substances. Understand? Now we'll see about types of mixtures. Okay, mixture is a type of matter. Again, mixture is classified into two important types based on the uniformity of particles. Okay, mixture also containing few particles. Based on the uniformity of particles, mixtures are classified into two types. That is homogeneous mixture and heterogeneous mixture. So first we'll see what is homogeneous mixture. Okay, if the particles are distributed uniformly in a compound, if the particles are distributed uniformly, then that is known as homogeneous mixture. Example, sugar solution. You just take a glass of water, to that add sugar. Okay, then it gives sugar solution. If you add 1 tablespoon of sugar to this glass of water, what happens? That sugar molecules completely dissolves in water and you can see only one layer. That means the particles of sugar are completely or uniformly distributed in water particles. So that It is known as homogeneous mixture. This mixture is contained two components, that is sugar molecules and water molecules. These sugar molecules are uniformly distributed in water molecule, so that it is known as homogeneous mixture. Sugar solution is an example of homogeneous mixture. Now we'll see heterogeneous mixture. What is heterogeneous mixture? If the particles are not distributed uniformly, okay, if the particles are not distributed uniformly, then those are known as heterogeneous mixture. Example, sand dissolved in water. Now I am taking a glass of water, okay, to that a little amount of sand is added. What happens? That sand particles comes and deposits at the bottom. Okay, then we can see two layers. One is water layer, another one is the layer which contains mud particles or sand particles. So that means that sand particles are not uniformly distributed in water. Then such type of mixtures are known as heterogeneous mixtures. If the particles are not distributed uniformly, then those are known as heterogeneous mixture. Example, sand present in water. So that sand particles do not dissolve uniformly in water, then that is an example of heterogeneous mixture. Okay, so these mixtures can be separated into its constituents by physical methods. Okay, by using physical methods we can easily separate these mixtures into their constituents. Example, a mixture which is containing iron and sulfur. Okay, a mixture which is containing iron and sulfur can be separated by using a magnet. Okay, then that method is known as magnetic separation. So this magnetic separation is an example of physical method. So a mixture containing iron and sulfur can be easily separated by using a magnet. That process is known as magnetic separation. Magnetic separation is an example of physical method. That means this is a mixture. Mixtures can be easily separated into their constituents by means of physical methods. Okay, that is about the classification of this matter. Now we'll see about the properties of matter. Properties of matter are mainly classified into two types. Whatever you take, the substance or the matter can exist in different physical states. Okay, different physical states. So based on that, they are mainly classified. Properties of the matter can be classified into two types, that is physical properties and chemical properties. Okay, properties of matter are classified into two types, that is physical properties and chemical properties. So now we'll see about physical properties. First, initially we'll discuss about physical properties. So to explain about this physical properties, I'm taking one of the example, rubber ball. Okay, if it is in yellow color, just imagine yellow color rubber ball I have taken. Okay, that yellow color rubber ball, by seeing we can say about its properties. Few physical properties of the yellow color rubber ball we can easily say. Okay, if a rubber ball is given to you, so by seeing we can say its physical state. A ball is always exist in which physical state? That is solid state. And shape of the ball also we know, that is it is in round shape or spherical shape. Now color of the ball also we can say, that is in yellow color. And smell, it smells to be like rubber. Okay, rubber is having a specific smell. Even that rubber ball will get that rubber smell. And it functions like bounces. Can it bounce? Is a ball obviously bounces. So all these properties by seeing we can easily say. Whatever the properties of a matter we can say by seeing, those are known as physical properties. So state of a substance we can say, shape of a matter we can say, color we can say, smell we can say by observing, and how it functions also we can say by observing a thing or matter. Then those type of properties are considered to be physical properties. Okay, now I am taking one more example, that is a block of sulfur, that is a rock, a small block of sulfur I have taken. So sulfur is an element. Okay, sulfurs, all metals can exist in the form of rocks. So a small piece of rock we have taken, that is considered to be block of sulfur. Okay, so that block of sulfur physical properties also we can easily say. Okay, always sulfur can exist in yellow in color. Okay, element, that is nature. So element, sulfur element can exist in yellow in color, and physical state we can say, so it is rocky, that means it is in solid state. Okay, and it is containing some strong odor. Odor is nothing but smell. Sulfur is containing a strong smell. That means all these three properties we can say immediately by observing a thing. Then that type of substances, that type of properties are said to be physical properties. Okay, now I am taking here the two examples whatever I explained here, that is rubber ball and sulfur, a block of sulfur. Now we'll see about the physical properties. So ball physical state is solid, even sulfur is also crystalline solid. Okay, and shape, so this is in round shape, it doesn't have any certain shape. Okay, now color, it is in yellow color, even it is in yellow in color. Now odor, so this is like rubber odor and it is containing a strong odor. Okay, the properties of these two matters are the things we can say immediately on observing. So those properties are said to be physical properties. That means finally we will conclude one point related to physical properties. Physical properties are those properties that we can measure or observe. Okay, whatever the properties we can observe or we can measure, those are known as physical properties. Example, color, length of a substance. So how many meters or centimeters is present, that is also one of the physical property. Mass, weight of a substance also we can say by observing. Area of a substance, texture of a substance, whether it is rough to touch or smooth to touch. Elasticity, whether it can enlarge or not, that is elasticity. Odor, odor is nothing but smell of a substance we can say. Melting points and boiling points also we can say by observing or measuring. Okay, so those properties are said to be physical properties. The properties which can able to measure or observe are said to be physical properties. That means matter is containing two different types of properties, physical and chemical properties, where physical properties can be explained by measure or observing them. Okay, that is about physical properties. About chemical properties, we'll learn or we'll see in next videos. Now we'll see briefly about the classification of matter once again. I'm just giving now brief explanation of about matter. Okay, matter is mainly classified into two types. Okay, that is pure substance. Okay, and next one, mixture. Pure substance is again classified into two types. That is element and compound. Okay, mixtures are classified into two types, that is and next heterogeneous. Okay, so this is simple classification of matter. Matter is a substance which has certain mass and occupies space. This matter is again classified into two types, mixture and pure substance. Okay, so mixtures are the compounds which contains two or more molecules or atoms. These are of two types, homogeneous and heterogeneous. In homogeneous, all the particles are uniformly distributed. In heterogeneous, the particles are not uniformly distributed. Now, pure substances. So, what are pure substances? The substances which contains only one kind of atom or molecule are known as pure substances. Okay. These pure substances are of again two types, elements and compounds. Elements are the pure substances which contains only one kind of atoms. Example, sodium, magnesium, silver, oxygen, hydrogen, all these are examples of elements. These elements cannot be separated by physical methods or chemical methods. Okay, either by using physical method or by using chemical methods, we cannot separate these elements. Now, compounds. So, these are the pure substances which contains two or more different types of atoms or molecules. Okay, example, we can take water and ammonia. Okay, so such water and ammonia are made up of two different types of elements in different ratios. These compounds can be separated by chemical means but not by physical means. Okay, that is about the classification of matter. Okay, along with the classification, in this video we have seen about physical properties of matter. In next video we'll discuss about the chemical properties. Thank you.